In this video, I will show you how to access price on a page if developer and custom data layer is not available. Hey, my name is Julius and welcome to the Analytics Mania YouTube channel, where I teach people how to work with Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics. And if you want to stay up to date with GTM, then consider subscribing. Let's say that you are on a page and you want to access a product price or maybe transaction total. Ideally, you should cooperate with a developer and ask him or her to push that information to the data layer. But sometimes that is not possible. Maybe a developer is very busy, or maybe there is no developer at all. In that case, there is an alternative approach called DOM scraping. This technique introduces more risk, but sometimes there is just no other option. Let's take a look. Below this video, you will find a link to my blog post where I share a bunch of different code snippets, like for example, this one or this one. In this video, I will be using these snippets. So if you want to copy the actual codes, then click the link below the video. So here I am on a demo page, and let's say that I want to access with Google Tag Manager the price, which is right here. Ideally, you would need to cooperate with a developer and ask to push this information to the data layer. That is hands down the best way. However, in some situations, you might not have access to a developer, or maybe your project doesn't even have one regular developer. Therefore, your another option, which is riskier, is to try to scrape the website and try to access this value on your own. However, if I do the right click on this price and click inspect, in this case, here's the problem. I have not only the actual price, which is right here, but I also have the word price and I have this euro sign. Now, platforms like Google Analytics, Facebook, or others, they do not accept this kind of format. Usually, you need to pass them only the actual number, which is this part. Luckily, I have a bunch of different code snippets that will help you do that. So if you click the link below the video and go to that blog post, you will see several options. Option 1, option 2, and option 3. These options depend on what do you want to access and how is that price displayed on a page. And there might be different options. For example, the price might be displayed like this, might be like this. Maybe there are some words before or after. So let's take a look what we have on my demo page. Here I have the word price, then the currency sign, and then the actual price that I want to access. So looking at my example in the option 1, this is covered. So I can use this snippet in order to access the value. Select the entire code snippet, copy it, and then go to Google Tag Manager, variables, and then in the user defined variables section, click new. Click variable configuration, custom JavaScript, and then paste the code. But just blindly copy pasting the code will not work. You still need to replace one part, which is this. You need to write a CSS selector that will pick this entire element, because first we have to pick this and then the rest of the code will take the wanted value out of that text. So if you haven't done that yet, then do the right click on the price, inspect, and let's take a look what do we have here. This is an element strong, but it is a direct child of an h3, which is heading 3, and its ID is price. So basically what we could do is that we can try to write a CSS selector that returns this particular element and it returns the text inside of it. So if you want to learn more about that topic, then check the description of this video where I link to the course. If you are thinking to write some CSS selector and you want to validate whether it is correct, you can do that by going to the console. Then you can clear everything from the console by clicking this icon and then enter the following command. Document query selector all, then open and close parentheses, then quotation marks, and now you can enter your CSS selector. So again, I will be targeting the element with ID price. In CSS, the ID is distinguished with a hashtag, so hashtag price. And if I click enter, I will get the list of all elements on a page that have this ID. And right now, there's only one element, and if I hover my mouse on it, you will see that this part is highlighted. So far, so good. Now, if I want to access the text of this element, because right now we are getting the full element and we are getting a lot of additional information about that element. So if I want to access just the first element's text, which is this entire string right here, then I should repeat the same command, but instead of using query selector all, I should use just query selector. This will return the first element that matches this CSS selector. And then I need to enter dot inner text. And if I do like this, this will return the text of this element. So right now we are just validating whether our CSS selector is correct. And it indeed is. So I just need to copy right now this part, and I need to enter it in the custom JavaScript variable code that I have previously pasted, like that. Now let's name this variable. I usually name them CGS, which is custom JavaScript, and then enter, let's say, product price, click save. Now let's test whether this is working properly. So click preview, then enter the URL of the page where you want to access that price, and click connect. I see that the preview mode has connected. Now let's go to the preview mode, then go to DOM ready, variables, and I see that my variable returns the correct price, which is without any words and any currency symbols. Let's take a look at another example. This time the price is much higher, and that price contains comma or a dot somewhere in the middle right here. So in this case, our code snippet should remove not only this part, but also should remove this comma. Therefore, the final result should be just 12, then 000.00. If this is your situation, then go back to my blog post and take a look at option number 2. As you can see, this will take the text and will remove that comma right here and some unnecessary text in front of it or afterwards. So copy this, then go to Google Tag Manager, open our existing product price variable, and then overwrite this existing code with the new code. However, you should memorize this selector right here because we are going to use it once again. So now I will remove this, paste this, and then enter my CSS selector like this. Click save. Refresh the preview mode. And now I am again on the demo page. And now if I go back to the preview mode and check the DOM ready, or let's say window loaded event, and then go to variables tab, I will see that the price is displayed correctly and all the unnecessary characters are now removed. Usually option number 1 and 2 are enough for most cases. However, in rare occasions, some marketing or analytics tools might require you to send not the text, or in other words, string, because in this case, this is a number, but it is surrounded by quotation marks here and here. In pretty rare occasions, you might be asked to send the number as the actual number type, which is without quotation marks here and here. So if this is your case, then take a look at option 3 in my blog post. Instead of returning the price surrounded by quotation marks, it will return just as a number. So we can try this out. I will copy the code, go back to Google Tag Manager, then open my current JavaScript variable, and then I will remove the current code and will add a new code. And once again, don't forget to replace the CSS selector, click save. And again, remember, this is now surrounded by quotation marks, but if I refresh the preview mode and apply my new code, this will now return number as a number like this. Don't worry about the missing dot 00, because if the price is, let's say, 12,000.00, that's in math just 12,000. Now, if the price would have been, let's say, $12,000.03, then you would also see dot 03 right here. So this is how you can extract product price from the website. However, keep in mind one very important thing, that if you are trying to scrape the website and read the values of its elements, you need to make sure that on that particular moment when you do that, the element actually exists on a page. So for example, if you want to send the product price when the page is loaded, never use the container loaded or any earlier event right here. You should be using this technique only when DOM ready happens on a page or on any other subsequent event, because the DOM ready means that the website's document is loaded and elements are ready to be accessed. I mean, there might be some nuances. For example, maybe the product price is injected even later on a page and it is injected dynamically. So in that case, even the DOM ready will not be enough, and maybe you will need to use window loaded or maybe some other event. There might be some nuances as well for single page applications, but when it comes to single page applications, I would highly recommend cooperating with a developer and asking to push the product data to the data layer instead. So just remember, If you try to access the price or any other element on a page on your own, always do that when the element actually exists on a page and when it is ready. Because on container loaded, the element might not always be ready. In this case, it is ready, but on some larger pages that are heavier and have many more elements, on container loaded event, that element will not be always available yet. So in many cases, the bare minimum would be to use the DOM ready trigger instead. So if you have some tags that fire on container loaded and they are trying to access the element, instead use the DOM ready or any other subsequent trigger that fires after the DOM ready. And one final tip is that maybe you already have some variable in your data layer that contains the price with the text or with some currency sign. So in that case, take a look at this option. In this code right here, you should insert your own variable that contains the price with some unwanted text. Insert the variable here, and then the rest of the code will do its magic and will remove the unwanted text, including currency signs. And that is how you can extract price from the page without a developer, but with Google Tag Manager. Remember, this is a risky approach. If the structure of the website's HTML changes, your price tracking might stop working. So if it is possible, always cooperate with a developer and always ask to push that information to the data layer. If you found this video useful, hit the thumbs up button below the video because it helps me continue working on this channel. Also, if you want to learn more about Google Tag Manager or Google Analytics 4, then consider subscribing to this channel. My name is Julius, this is Analytics Mania, and I'll see you in the next video.